grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear friends, today we celebrate the seventh Sunday of Lent time. Today we are called to reflect on this virtue called gratitude. How grateful are we being? Have we shown it in all that we do? And have we appreciated God for the things He has given us, blessings and privileges? What about those around us? For the good times we have enjoyed with those around us, have we shown gratitude? Today we pray that God, who continues to show us His love, who continues to show us His goodness, who continues to grant us all our hearts and desires, since we have so Christ. And as we grant our hearts and desires, He will make us to show gratitude to all of you, since we have so Christ. My dear friends, for us to explain this one, we must call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have guilty sin in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous thoughts. Therefore, I ask the blessed Mary the Ever Virgin, all the angels, your mighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you. We adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins. Receive our prayer. You are still at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the only one. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ. In the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty Heavenly God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and desires of those who entreat you, pour out the mercy upon us, to pardon what conscience dreads, and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. We make our prayer to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Let me sing for my beloved a love song concerning his vineyard. My beloved had a vineyard on a very fertile hill. He dug it and cleared it of stones and planted it with choice vines. He built a watchtower in the midst of it and hewed out a wine vat in it. And he looked for it to yield grapes, but it yielded wild grapes. And now, O inhabitants of Jerusalem, and men of Judea, judge, I beg you, between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I had not done in it? When I looked for it to yield grapes, why did it yield wild grapes? And now I will tell you what I will do to my vineyard. I will remove its hedge, and it shall be devoured. I will break down its wall, and it shall be trampled down. I will make it a waste. It shall not be pruned or mowed, and briars and thorns shall grow. I will also command the clouds that they rain no rain upon it. For the vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and men of Judea are his pleasant planting. And he looked for justice, but behold, bloodshed. For righteousness, but behold, a cry. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm.
The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
have no anxiety about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep your heart and your minds in Jesus Christ. Finally, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, do. And the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord. May you rise for them. Alleluia.
Afterwards, he sent a son to them, saying, "They will respect my son." But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, "This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and have his inheritance." Blessed be my gospel. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, from our readings of today, we will see what we call revise, that is, eating up a virtue. And this vice is eating up a virtue we could see in our society of today. And just as Christ puts before us in this parable of today, the landlord, having built his wonderful farmland or yard, the farm, made it wonderful, employed or had tenants to always take care of it while he traveled and everything. He sent the servants to come get returns from the farmland, but no return was made. Instead of the servants to come back, they were killed. And when eventually he saw this happen, he sent his own son, "At least they will respect my son." But eventually his son came, and what they could say was, "Oh, there comes the heir. Come, let us kill him and have his inheritance." Ingratitude. And that is what we see in our society for today. William George Jordan has this to say about ingratitude. He said, "Ingratitude is a crime more despicable than revenge. Revenge is only returning evil for evil, while ingratitude returns evil for good." And that is what we see in our society of today. A good number are full of this ingratitude. We're able to be thankful and grateful to God for the blessings and the privileges God has shown them through their various individuals that come to rescue them at one point or the other in their lives. What do we hear? They come around, they will kill. I'm sure we hear the story of the one who was killed by his own PA. Did you hear of that story? That is ingratitude. And that is exactly what Christ is telling us. What he wrote so many years ago, they are still at war today. What is the cause? Greed. What is the cause? Selfishness. We are not contented with what we have. And what others have even done for us, we are not appreciative of it. Pride will not allow us to see the good in others and to appreciate the good that are in others. And that is where all these hatred are coming from. Why must it be him that God has given us? Why must it be that he is the only one who has the privilege enough? Ingratitude. It's a vice that is eating up our society. And we must try and see how we can do away with it. One way or the other, we might not have the full-blown cause of ingratitude in our lives. But one way or the other, it is there. An element of to be ingrate is there. The gift of life, it does something there. Do we have any control over it? I'm sure we don't have any control over it. And I will say, "Thank you, Lord, for that life." We slept yesterday and we are up this morning. Did we say thank you for it? If we have not said thank you for that miracle that happened last night and this morning, then we are that element of being asked to be us.
So today, Christ himself wants us not to be like these tenants, because he wants us to shun these vices in us, to be more grateful, be more thankful, be more appreciated for the things he has done in us and with us. For the love shown to us by friends, colleagues, and even those who are benefactors that we do not even know, he wants us to show gratitude for them. We are glad for this Mass. The whole essence of this Mass is that we show gratitude to God for all he has done. Are we willing to show gratitude to him for all he has done for us? The blessings we have received from him, have we shown enough gratitude to him for that? My dear friends, today is not time for many long epistles, as I have written, but for us to reflect on this virtue, to see if truly we are grateful enough, if truly we are grateful for the love he has shown us, for the mercy he has shown us, for the protection he has shown us, and for the goodness he has bestowed upon us. Are we grateful? These are ways that Christ wants us to reflect upon, to really know if truly, as Christians, as a child of his, if we are really grateful. We pray, good Lord, we want to endow us more with his goodness, to remain grateful for to him for all he has given to us. This is our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not me, but substantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayer of the Faithful. God's word is powerful and his study.
Strengthened by his teaching, we approach our God for what we need.
For the gift of gratitude to God, may we be people of thankfulness, aware of what God has done for us, and may our gratitude to God be reflected in our lives of concern for other people. Lord, hear us. For the gift of peace, may we experience peace in our lives, the peace that comes from listening to the gospel, reflecting on its meaning and living by its teaching in mind and heart and deed. Lord, hear us. For the gift of producing good fruits. May our lives be fruitful in God's service and in our living by the gospel teaching. May God's purpose be fulfilled and may we share with others the gifts that God has generously given us. Lord, hear us. For the gift of wisdom. The stone rejected by the builders became the cornerstone. May we have the gift of wisdom to discern the signs of the times, and may we be open to what God wants in the church and in the community. Lord, hear us. Prayer for Nigeria in distress. All our hopes are merciful, Father. You are the God of justice, law, and peace. You rule over all the nations of the earth. Power and might are in your hands, and no one can withstand you. We present our country, Nigeria, before you. We praise and thank you, for you are the source of all we have. We are sorry for all the sins we have committed and for the good deeds we have failed to do. In your loving forgiveness, keep us safe from the punishment we deserve. Lord, we are weighed down not only by uncertainties, but also by moral, economic, and political problems. Who confidently turn to you, God of infinite goodness, our strength in adversity, our health in weakness, our comfort in sorrow. Be merciful to us, your people. Spare this nation, Nigeria, from chaos, anarchy, and doom. Bless us with your kingdom of justice, love, and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In the silence of our hearts, we pray for our personal and community needs. We pray with Mary, Mother of God, as we say, Hail Mary.
God of all consolation, your truth sets us free. Your way leads to life. Grant what we need through Christ.
Amen. From the Christ having people in 365. 365.
Thank you.
Lord your mighty power.
May the Lord has set aside the eyes of thy hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our kingdom and the glory of his kingdom.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal, for having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you have raised up Jesus from the dead. We hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we are praying. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. May it holy, therefore, this day to pray, by sending down your condemned and due for, so that it may us, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Alfred Martins, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of your resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, our blessed fathers, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to go ahead with our life, and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
at the Savior's command and prompted by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of God be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
sick. Jesus does not do that, and he calls you as his. But then, on our own, we pray to God to come to you with his goodness and blessings to Christ our Lord. And I welcome to you with Ali, Sarah, and Sue. We pray to you, Ali, Sarah, Sue, one thing that's going to come out. And grant to you, because of kind of perseverance, to Christ our Lord. Beloved, be with you. The next God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is here.
And we rest and we go in one time, please.